Well, for more expert analysis on this now, I'm joined by business columnist Terry McCrann. Terry, great to see you again and thanks for joining us. Economists have been pushing for an interest rate cut. We've heard many call for that. But Michele Bullock today made it absolutely clear that a cut isn't on the cards anytime soon, no time in the next 6 months, which probably puts the first potential rate cut in the first quarter of next year.
Which might work out quite well for the government if it has an election in the normal course, Sharri. But I thought, looking at Jim Chalmers' comments today, I thought I saw signs of fear in those eyes of his, where he really thought that there's a prospect that rather than get a rate cut as you move into the election campaign, you might actually face a rate hike. I think we can be very thankful to Michele Bullock. She was absolutely crystal clear in describing the state of play, and that was inflation is too high. There was absolutely no prospect of a rate cut anytime soon. And the Reserve Bank was looking seriously at hiking rates today and will keep that possibility on the table going forward. Mm. Now, the only thing that's going to save us from a rate hike, Sharri, is if the economy does go over that cliff. And that's not exactly an attractive prospect on the other hand.
No, absolutely. Look, we heard the Treasurer today argue that he's successfully walking this narrow path, avoiding a recession, unlike the very real risk in the US at the moment. Do you give him credit for this?
I give him zero credit for it, Sharri, because, and I think the Reserve Bank in its quieter moments would also give him zero credit for it, because the government is the one that's causing the difficulties. The government, the one, as you've indicated, Sharri, with that massive immigration program, which is forcing up rents, forcing up the cost of living, putting great stress on Australian families. What the government's done with energy prices, everybody understands what's happening as a consequence of that. What it's done in the industrial relations space, where it's making it very hard to get productivity improvements, all those things are not only making life tough for Australians and for business, it's also making it tough for the Reserve Bank to think about cutting rates anytime soon. So the buck stops precisely at Jim Chalmers' desk. He's not the guy that's delivering some sort of benefit. He's making life tough for everyone.
What did you think about the RBA governor's comments when she spoke about government spending being an issue? I mean, that's quite rare for her to say that, isn't it?
Well, absolutely. I mean, it's because but it's just the basic reality, Sharri, that if the government is adding to demand and demand is the problem, there's too much demand chasing what's produced in the economy. That's what causes inflation. Well, then you know. The government is part of that problem, but that's only a small part of it. And she didn't want to get into a direct assault on the government. And she certainly doesn't want to get into a situation where she's got to put up rates precisely because the government is creating the problem.
Mm-hmm. All right, Terry McCrann, you always are spot on and have such brilliant analysis. We appreciate you joining us on your show and look forward to reading more in the Herald Sun tomorrow.